Hey, tubers, look at this. Two jugs of oil. That could only mean one thing. Yes, yes, it's time to change the oil on the 560. It's been a little while. This tractor hadn't been started in at least 3 weeks, possibly longer, but at least 3 weeks. But right now, all the oil, every bit of it's down in the pan. So I'm going to go ahead and take this opportunity to drain all of the oil out because it's all in the pan, not scattered all up in the engine. And let's get started. I'll be right back. Okay, the first thing we're going to do, I've got you looking down in my bucket. It's really hard to get both sides of this, so I've stuck y'all down in the bucket today. Usually it's on my nut. And that broke loose fairly easy. There we go. Wow, that's a little bit dark, tubers. Might be falling down on the job. I might have to change oil more often, eh? Just kidding. I can't afford that. Alright, see what this does. Alright, tubers, we're coming off of here with a CarQuest number 85797. Come on, baby! There we go. I'll be right back. I gotta get a wrench for this. All right, see, this has come unscrewed. This is one thing, I love these spin-on filters, but I don't like the way this centerpiece, it likes to get loose. There, that should be good. I'll be right back. Okay, as I said, I had the CarQuest 85797. This time we're going on with a OEM filter, if you will. Case IH oil filter number 398080R2. For those of you who didn't get that, 398080R2. This is what we're going to put on there. First, as you know, don't forget to lube up your rubber because you don't want it to be dry and snag and get all wrinkled. A wrinkled rubber will leak on you. I promise it will. You want to put some lubrication on that. And this is lubed up. We're good to go here. And then if you want to, you can put some in your threads inside. Not necessary, just me being anal. Okay, slide this in here.
Okay. And that should be good.
I'll be right back. Hey y'all, tubers. I showed you this on the Oliver oil change, and since that time I've enhanced it a little bit. Oh, hang on just a second. I forgot at the beginning of this video, I always say when it is. Today is Saturday the 12th of October. It's in the afternoon. It's very hot, very humid. I'm sweating my butt off today. Anyway, I've enhanced this. You'll see some pictures at the end. This hose can't come off of the funnel. I've got it pinned with two screws that go into the middle. And so the hose stays. This dog hook, dog leash thing clips on here. And I've got a bolt and a nut on a jack chain with a stainless screw threaded into the top, so that hangs on to it. It stays in place when I put my oil. And like I say, there's pictures of all this, so you'll be able to see this up close. I know you can't see it right now on video. All right, I'll be right back. Okay, the way this works, this hose slides inside of my hole right there, and it goes in about an inch and a half, so it's safe. Comes up here, the chain, there's a little play here for the weight of the oil. When I fill it with the funnel, inside the funnel, it gets heavier. This chain goes over my manifold, and then my nut and bolt are hanging back here, and they're not coming off of there, so we're safe this way when I fill this with oil. And I can actually let it hang a little more if I want to, but that's good right there. All right, let's get some oil in this tractor. All right, unlike the other two tractors that take right at 6 quarts, this 560 takes 9. So I'll be using this entire jug and then almost a full jug after this. Okay, what I've done, I poured in 8 and almost a half, about 8 and just shy, 8 3/8. Well, so we'll call it 8 and a half. I put 8 and a half quarts in, and I'm gonna let it settle out. I'll start the engine, run it a few minutes, and then turn it off and settle it out, and then I'll check my dipstick, because last time when I put a full 9 quarts, it was a smidge too full. All right, there'll be more. All right, tubers, oil has changed. First start in 3 weeks or so. Let's do it.